Hello, VLearn, Virtual Learning Network. We will do MCS 15 Block 1, Unit 4 Group Discussions and Unit 5 Managing Organizational Structure. In previous session, we have done Unit 1 and 2. Topics to be covered are Introduction, Reading and Writing Skills, Study Skills, Language Focus, Vocabulary, Grammar, Connectives. Topics to be covered are Introduction, Ability to Influence and Lead, Reading, The Role of Manager, Vocabulary, Leadership, Speaking and Listening, Language Focus, Degree of Probability, Writing Reports, and Last Summary. First, let us start with Introduction. Group discussion are part of the admission procedure in many institutes of higher education. Besides, they also play a major role in the recruiting process for the various administrative and high-level posts in business organizations. We can say that group discussion is a methodology, or in a simple language, you may call it an interview process or a group activity. It is used as one of the best tools to select the prospective candidates in a competitive perspective. GD may be used by an interviewer at an organization, colleges, or even at the different types of management competitions. It is used by an organization to gauge whether the candidate has certain personality traits and or skills that it desires in its members. In this methodology, the group of candidates is given a topic or a situation, given a few minutes to think about the same, and then asked to discuss the topic among themselves for 15 to 20 minutes. So we can say that it is very useful tool to screen the candidate's potentials as well as their skills. Now next, managing organizational structure primarily involves a relationship between the leader and the team. In this unit, you will learn about managing people at all levels of organizations, motivating teams, dynamic of leadership, managing conflicts, taking and implementing decisions. Another traits are communication skills, interpersonal skills, leadership skills, motivational skills, team building skills, analytic and logical skills, reasoning ability, different thinking, initiative, assertiveness, flexibility, creativity, ability to think on one's feet. Why GD are implemented commonly? GD stand for group discussion. Evaluate how can function as a part of a team. As a manager or as a member of organization, you will always be working in teams. Therefore, how you interact in a team becomes an important criterion for your selection. Managers have to work in a team and get best results out of teamwork. Now next, reading and writing skills. Reading. Speak first only if you have something sensible to say. Second, give the patient ear to dissenting views. Last, try to resolve contradictions, synthesize arguments. Writing, be assertive but not aggressive. Ensure you get enough air time. Build up a good knowledge base. Some other tips for group discussion. First, understand. Understand the topic before attempting to contribute. Second, speak. Try and get a chance to speak. If you cannot get a chance to speak, make sure your chance. Initiate. Take the initiative to begin the discussion if possible. Structure. Structure arguments logically. Summaries. Summaries the discussions effectively. Involve. Take active part throughout the GD. Assert. Be assertive. Articulate. Work continuously towards articulating your ideas into meaningful sentences to make the best impact. Be clear in your speech. Emphasize. Use non-verbal communication to emphasize points. Listen. Be an attentive listener. Quality, not quantity, matters. It is not how much you say, but what you say that is more important for reading and writing skills. Now next, study skills. Group discussions are often used as a part of selection recruitment procedure by institutions and business organizations. If you are sit on the group discussion, then you have to follow some tips for the topic which you have choose and given in the group discussion, such as intelligence, depth of understanding, ability to think independently, ability to articulate thoughts, ability to appreciate another's point of view, ability to relate other people. So we can say that it would be extremely helpful to keep these in mind when you participate in group discussion. First, command over spoken English. It should be logical, coherent, correct and appropriate. Knowledge base. It should be authentic information, genuine facts and figures. Convincing power. You have a good convincing power and forceful attitude. Discourse management. Coping with the twist and turns of arguments. Body language. Eye contact, body posture and attentiveness. Maturity. Candidate should not bully others or take undue advantage to prove himself or herself as a leader. Listening, intelligent and analytical. Supplementing, responding and adding to what other has said before initiating a fresh turn. Initiative and assertiveness. Beneficial team behavior. First, initiate discussion. Second, seek information and opinions. Suggest procedure for reaching a goal. Clarify or elaborate ideas. Summarize. As a gatekeeper, direct conversational traffic, avoid simultaneous conversation. Subdue dominant talkers, make room for reserved and shy people. Keep the discussion for disagreeing. Subdue dominant talkers, make room for reserved and shy people. Keep the discussion from disaggressing. Be flexible and creative in resolving differences. Now, language focus. Stating an opinion. It seems to be, in my view, I tend to think, it's obvious that I believe. Clearly, my opinion about this topic. Expressing agreement. I totally agree. I agree entirely. I quite often. I could not agree more. Absolutely. Precisely. I think you are right. Now, making suggestion. I suggest that we could. Perhaps we should. It might be worth. What about? Why do not we? We can choose other options. Reformulating. To put that another way. If I follow you correctly. So what you are saying is, does that mean? Are you saying, I think we should now move on to consider. Can we go on to think about? Now next vocabulary. Word collocations are those words which occur in groups or pairs naturally or habitually. These are called word collocations. Examples: build a consensus and a quick temper, restore order, take decisions, resolve contradictions, synthesize arguments, accommodate dissenting viewpoints, maintain eye contact, summarize the discussion. Now more example for word collocations: provide a fresh directions, convey ideas convincingly, accept responsibility, define your objective, and so on. Now grammar linking words. Linking words are those words who connect ideas and sentences. When we speak or write English, we can use linking words to give examples, add information, summarize, sequence information, give a reason or result, or to contrast ideas. The bold words are linking words. For example, in most GDs, the opening speaker is the person who is likely to get the maximum uninterrupted airtime. At the start, most other participants in the GD are still trying to understand the basic issues in the topic, or are too nervous to speak and are waiting for someone else to start. Therefore, the evaluators get the best chance to observe the opening speaker. Now, this is a double-edged sword. Now, next, ability to influence and lead. Read the following statement and rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 5 for each of the following statement. First, not strong in this area. 5, very strong in this area. First, competence. The ability to do a job successfully. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Doing the job better than expected. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Second, discretion. Ability to distinguish between attitude. Ability to maintain a positive attitude in a negative situations. Now, reading the role of manager. The role of a manager is closely related to the powers that are given at different levels of the organization: top level, middle level and lower level management. The function of a manager can be divided into formal and informal aspects. Formal functions are to win, contract, delegate duties, express opinion and take judicious decisions. Informal functions of a manager are related to personal style, ability to influence, charisma, concern for colleagues at all levels. Example, the way a manager interacts with other people. A manager leads the team with example and takes the business towards the goals in spite of expected or unexpected changes. We can say that a manager should be able to deal intelligently with tricky situations. Keeping in mind existing conflicts of interest in the organization. For this, the executive should be able to resolve or manage his or her inner conflicts so that his or her decisions are strongly grounded in reality. Greater attention must be given to the organizational structure and creating a strong feeling of security, or the organization will greatly suffer. Now, next vocabulary, leadership. First, we should know about what does mean of leadership. Leadership is the art of motivating a group of people to act towards achieving a common goal. Leadership is a process by which an executive can direct, guide, and influence the behavior and the work of others towards accomplishment of a specific goals in a given situation. Leadership is the ability of manager to induce that subordinates to work with confidence and zeal. Leadership is the potential to influence behavior of others. It is also defined as the capacity to influence a group towards the realization of a goal. Leaders are required to develop future vision and to motivate the organizational members to want to achieve the visions. According to the Davis, leadership is the ability to persuade others to seek defined objectives enthusiastically. It is the human factor which binds a group together and motivates it towards goals. Characteristics of leadership. It is an interpersonal process in which a manager is into influencing and guiding workers towards attainment of goals. It denotes a few qualities to be present in a person who includes intelligence, maturity, and personality. It is a group process. It involves two or more people interacting with each other. A leader is involved in shaping and molding the behavior of the group towards accomplishment of organizational goals. Leadership is a situation bound. There is no best style of leadership. It all depends upon tackling with the situations. There are so many aspects that binds employees and corporation together, but it is a leader who builds a relationship. He or she is not primarily a profit generating robot or someone who ensured that the company should survive and prosper at any cost. Such leaders are themselves lead by policies and not principles. They abandon their policies as soon as the profit graph changes. Their commitment to the organization takes a new turn as the profit dips. They talk about controlling the expenditure but keep drawing astronomical salaries for themselves. Whereas equality and opportunity rights are violated for junior staff. Now, next is speaking and listening. Listen to this conversation carefully. Here, workers are discussing their work environment of their organization. The dialogue between two friends, worker A, we can come and go to our work as we please. You know, we follow flexi timing. B, it cannot be possible. There should be registers where the workers check in and check out. A, would you believe this? We may even be asked to decide how much of the profit to share with our employers and how much to invest in the company. B, you must be joking. In that we can say the dialogues between two friends moving gradually. Now next, language focus degree of probability. Here are some ways which you could use to get people to do things. Requesting, I would like, could you ask, could you please, do you think you could, would you mind, for granting permission or refusing. Sure, go ahead, by all means. Here are some more ways we can use to express ideas. I am sorry, but. Second, now I am afraid you cannot, because. Criticizing and complaining. I am sorry to have to say this, but I think you may have forgotten. It may have slipped your mind. There may have been a misunderstanding about. I am afraid norms have been forgotten. If suppose you are appreciating and encouraging to someone, thanks for your cooperation without it. I would like to extend my personal appreciation. We could do it because of team effort. Each member contributed beyond. We are back in business because of. Grammar, modals. The modal verbs are a special group of auxiliary verbs. We use them before other verbs to express certain meanings, for example, permission, ability, possibility, certainty. We list below some of the modals and their functions. Can, use for ability, request, permission. Could, ability, possibility, polite request and use for past tense. Would, it use for polite request. Will, use for offer and expressing the future. Shall, use for suggestion and offer. Should, use for advice. Here are some examples of modals. I can speak English. I could go to the cinema. May I go to cinema? You must see the new film with Brad Pitt. Shall I carry your bag? Sometimes he would bring me some flowers. Now next, writing reports. A document containing information organized in a narrative, graphic or tabular form, prepared on ad hoc, periodic, recurring, regular or as a required basis. Reports may refer to specific periods, events, occurrence or subjects and may be communicated or presented in oral or written form. The procedure leading to writing of reports would involve different stages. First, investigating the sources of information. Second, taking notes and interpreting and analyzing the facts. Third, writing the outline of the report and actual report. Fourth, editing and revising the report. We can say that most reports have at least 3 and sometimes 4 parts. These include introduction, body, conclusion and recommendation. The introduction should state the subject and the purpose of the report. It may also include any background information that is necessary for the reader to follow the report. The introduction is often a good place to refer briefly to any conclusion that may be drawn. In the body of report, the writer must include a clearly organized account of a subject of the report. For example, the result of the survey carried out, an account of the fire in the factory and the damage to life and property. The conclusion of the report contains a summary of the finding and their significance. Finally, in the recommendation are included any suggestion that the writer may make based on the facts of the situation. The recommendations indicate any practical course of action that may be taken. These are often the most important part of the report, and their adoption or rejection depend on how they are presented. Summary. In this unit, we learn about what is group discussion and types of group discussion, the importance of GD as a tool for assessment criteria for GDs, language used in GDs and do's and do not for GDs, how to take part in an actual group discussion and know about the word collocations. Moreover, we try to give the linguistic competence in managing various levels of the organization, participating as a team member as well as a leader. As we know that these things are important for the professional terms. Thank you. Happy learning, be learning.